update, I-55M, found out wife, 52F, cheated and daughters knew about it. This will most likely be the first and last update, therefore it will be lengthy. I stated I'd publish an update a week after my article, but things didn't go as quickly as I expected, and I also needed some time to internalize everything. So I'm writing to give you an update now that I'm feeling more at ease. Last week, as several of you suggested, I took my youngest daughter out to lunch. During lunch, I asked her if she had anything she wanted to tell me. I'm not sure whether it was my expression or tone, but she got what I was saying right away. She sobbed and gave me the whole tale. She could observe her mother kissing another guy in our house a few years ago. My ex-wife allegedly urged the guy to leave and sat down with our daughter. She said that it was a momentary mistake of judgment, but she was relieved that our daughter intervened. She said it was a one-time blunder and asked her not to say anything to me since she knew I'd simply walk away from her and our family. My daughter said she promised to keep it a secret because she trusted her mother. She then shared it with my other two girls. As you could expect, they were both taken aback. My oldest apparently did not accept the narrative of the one-time kiss. My youngest happened to stroll into the living room and see them kissing for the first time. She assured them that she would address the situation with their mother. I couldn't be more proud of her for taking on this weight. According to what my youngest knows, my oldest told her mother about her cheating on me and threatened to tell me if she didn't come clean. However, the mother always had an excellent reason, for the last 5 years, to put it off. Whether it was our employment situation, a sick family, or whatever else, there was always a strong reason to explain why adding this on top of what was going on with me would be disastrous. I informed her at the conclusion of lunch that I would contact her two sisters to talk. She insisted on being a part of the discussion. That's okay. I texted my two children and told them I needed to speak to them right now. So we immediately set up a call. Part of me feels they knew what I wanted to speak about, and I informed them about what occurred with their mother, which their sister had told me about. They both began weeping, saying they were sorry, that they wanted to inform me and so on. To cut a long tale short, I informed them I wasn't angry with them. I expressed my regret that they had to bear this burden for so long and assured them that I would always love them. When it came to their mother, I informed them I was leaving because I couldn't picture myself being with someone who had deceived me. But I told her I'd speak to her first before making any decisions since it's the least I could do. I instructed them not to tell their mother anything since I was going to have a chat with her that evening. At the end of the day, I get home, and my wife is already here, as usual, chatting about her day, etc. I told her I had a fascinating conversation with our daughter. She recognized what I was saying right away. She began weeping, claiming it was only a kiss and that she was frightened of losing me for such a tiny thing since she knows how much I value trust and so on, particularly in my career. To be honest, I expected watching her weep to make me cry, but it didn't. I informed her that the paperwork will be sent to her by courier the following day, and that we would proceed. Then I went to our bedroom, gathered my belongings, and departed. I had no idea where I was heading, but I couldn't remain in our house any longer. I booked a downtown hotel and contacted my youngest to inform her that I would not be staying at home tonight. She said she was going to stay with a friend tonight to avoid having to face her mother, but since I was gone, she asked if she could stay with me. Without a doubt, I told my two other girls that their sister and I would be spending the night in a hotel. When they asked whether we could talk as a group, I answered sure. During that conversation, I informed them what the following steps would be, according to my lawyer. I also made it clear to them that they are my daughters and that I adore them. Despite everyone's advice, I couldn't stop myself from telling them that a part of me was wounded that they hadn't told me anything. I told them that I believed we had a deep relationship and that we could talk about anything. They began to weep and apologize, so I told them that no matter what had occurred, they were my daughter and I loved them. However, I informed them that it would take some time for me to resume our normal behavior. I told them I was thinking of taking a lengthy journey to clear my head, and my eldest said I should do it if I needed to. After that, we just went to bed. The mother contacted me when my daughter and I were eating breakfast the following morning. I didn't want to pick up the phone, but my daughter insisted on speaking with me. I agreed, but I turned on the speaker. I could tell she'd been drinking all night as soon as I picked up the phone. She began weeping, saying me she loved me, that we were destined to be together, that this would be awful for the kids and so on. I told her the kids were grown up and didn't need us anymore. We did our best, and now it's up to them to establish their own lives. Suddenly, she became very hostile, threatening to take all I own, to ensure that my firm goes bankrupt, to tell our girls that I physically beat her, and so on. I was so taken aback that I simply gazed at my daughter, who, like me, couldn't believe what she was hearing. I opted to end the conversation and told her that my lawyer will contact her. Daughter and I had no idea what to say to one another. It's as if the person who had been with us for 2 decades suddenly transformed into someone else. She got a message from her mother 5 minutes later, informing her that they needed to chat. Because my daughter was terrified, I instructed her not to respond. Anyway, the mother was plainly inebriated, so that conversation was certain to fail. I told her I'd be staying at this hotel until everything was sorted, and she could stay with me if she wanted. We held another group call with my 2 other daughters to inform them what had transpired, and they were astounded. I went to visit my attorney and briefed him of the events that had occurred. He reassured me that there was nothing to be worried about. The mother has a well-paying professional career and is in a comfortable financial position. Knowing her affluent circumstances, I run a firm that employs 50-100 people, and as a result, a judge will never jeopardize my business interests. She will get half of our assets, property, automobiles, and so on. But she should not be entitled to a penny from my funds, nor should she be allowed to make any claims against my company. My daughter has told me that she is terrified of coming to our house with her mother, because she is concerned that she would be held responsible. I told her that I'd get her a place downtown, and that she could come and live with me for a while, either temporarily until she thought she'd be able to return or until she went off to college. Her mother's scream over the phone, I feel, caused her a great deal of anguish. I'll inform her that if she feels the need, I can put her in touch with someone who can help her, such as a counselor. Now we'll have to watch how she reacts to it. The mother was given the documents and is said to have gone insane with our family, her and mine. She tried to reach us via her family, but my eldest just unplugged them. His understanding of who I am, on the other hand, has only resulted in his offering his support. He realizes that I would never do anything like this without a good purpose behind it. As a result, here we are. My divorce is on the horizon, and my daughter is staying with me until she is ready to return to her family. It has been brought to my attention that the mother has written to me. I may meet with her, but my attorney strongly recommends against it. Given that he mentioned that there is nothing to gain and everything to lose, I'm inclined to trust him. Concerning myself, I will not go to Thailand until I am certain that my youngest child is in a secure area. As a result, if I do decide to go, it will most likely be after high school. I'm not sure how our everyday life will unfold, but we'll see how things turn out. I doubt I'll provide another update unless anything significant happens. So, once again, I'd want to express my gratitude for all of your assistance. No way in hell did I ever see myself in that situation, and I hope no one else does either. Thank you very much for your help.